Yo, it's your boy CJ, and we back at it like a crack addict with a bad habit. And today is a Webby day. We are reacting to our boy Webby. I'm kind of late on this a bit, but whatever. Better late than never, right? But yo, before I get into that, look it. I got Webby's merch, and it's the Chris Webby Canadian Tour sweater. And I actually went to that tour. I went to the Opera House on May 10th, I believe it was. I did get sick and didn't get to see Webby perform. I can admit that, which sucks so much. That's another story for another time, because that actually is a decent little story. There's a lesson for that story. Let me just put it that way. We got another reaction, a Chris Webby reaction. And it's called Pearly Gates. I don't know if this is going to be kind of a sad song, him talking about death, heaven. I have no idea what he's got to say. I didn't even know he believed in heaven, or he might not. We're gonna see how this goes through, but enough of these shenanigans, let's get into it. ADHD. Quick little thought that I wanted to say. He has a label, I think, Chris Webby, and that's ADHD. Unless that's like his merch company, I forget. But I wonder if Webby's gonna be finding people and putting people onto his label. That'd be so cool. I'd love to see that. Yo, there's like a secret door and everything. Sheesh, okay. I've been showered with champagne and no everything. Way. They say my name when they notice me. When I'm gone, they gon' wish they would. Yo, his voice sounds so good. It's probably not like the machines are probably trying to make his voice better. The auto-tune, maybe there's auto-tune or pitch, the pitch level thingy. They're probably working his voice to make it sound good, right? But I don't know, that might not be true. His raspiness really comes out and it sounds good too. When I'm gone, they gon' wish they were coming. Cause you ain't never met a soul like okay, me. Talk your shit. Yeah, I'm a rare one. Since I started back at square one. Give it everything I got, I never spare yep. none. I've been a light in the dark for them like a flare. I've been the light in the dark just like a flare gun. Oh my goodness, like a flare gun when you're like, just think about it. You're in a ship, right? You're stranded, nowhere to go, right? It's probably nighttime. That flare, you shoot it up in the air so hopefully somebody sees you, and it's probably a nice little light in the dark when you're out there. Think about it. Yo, that was fire. We got to go back. That deserves a Don DeMarco. Bang, bang, bang. Everything I got, I never spare none. I've been a light in the dark for them like a flare gun. While I got a baddie in the caddy with her hair done. Baddie in the caddy with her hair done. Yo, that was slick. That was slick. I really like that. All right, let's go. Been a light in the dark for them like a flare gun. While I got a baddie in the caddy with her hair done. Pulling up like Dean Martin, carving my lane in the game. All flame, this a arson. Woo, all flame, that's an arson. You know what? Arsenal, right? Arson means, right? Sheesh, yo. That was a flame bar. I got some bars up my sleeve, too. Dean Martin carving my lane in the game, all flame. This arson. Smoke in the range with a strain from the garden. They know the name, got the fame for a bargain. Just hard work, I ain't sell my soul. I had many a chance, but I tell them no. Yo, that skipped out on me. Yo, YouTube, don't be skipping out. Or my Wi-Fi, come on. Many a chance, but I tell them no. Fuck the world. Anyone who's independent knows, and still they treat me like royalty wherever I go. I'm that genie in the lamp, son. You ain't never seen. Listen close. I'ma show you what the real one means, and there's no in between. That's the fact of the matter. I ain't after the happily ever after. I'm after leaving a legacy. Yo, the happily ever after. What the
real one means, and there's no in between. That's the fact of the matter. I ain't after the happily ever after. I'm after leaving a legacy.
Ooh, he doesn't want easy life. He wants to leave a legacy, so when somebody like wants to put on some hip hop and they're talking about maybe white rappers, he wants to hear Webby come out of their mouth at one point. Yeah, Eminem probably the first one, but he wants to hear Webby come out of that person's mouth in the next 60 years. That's what he's trying to get through, yeah. Get through to ya.
It's a fact of the matter. I ain't after the happily ever after. I'm after leaving a legacy. Leave the next gen with the recipe. Living on through the lyrics and the melody. Whether I go tomorrow or it's in my late 70s, I guarantee that you motherfuckers gon' remember me. Dodging where the devil be, trying to forge another path.
playing to my specialties, living through my fucking raps. Keep the microphone with me like my other half, cause no matter where the fuck we at, I've been
showered. Yo, he married to that mic, pretty much. He's saying, yo, that's his twin brother. It's pretty much his wife right now on the road, his mic. Yo, that's fire. Let's go. Well, not on the road, but in his studio. Like my other half, cause no matter where the fuck we at, I've been showered with champagne. Yo, this is fire. They say my name when they notice me. When I'm gone, they gon' wish they were coming. Okay, another hook coming, or another verse. Let's hear this. Oh, yo, he's laying in a coffin right now. Till I'm in that black hearse, pulling up in the box. It's a lost cause, even trying to come for the spot. Okay. When I really leave, then you'll see what you all got. Good luck filling my shoes, I'm a size y'all not. Yo, he's pretty much saying, yo, y'all are sleeping on me for so long, and once I do die and probably get the respect that I deserve, y'all are gonna be missing me. Y'all are gonna be listening to all these trash rappers, and you're gonna be like, oh shucks, I wish we had Webby. Well, guess what? When you did have Webby, you didn't respect him enough. Well, not respect, but you slept on him too much. You know what I'm saying? Like, tisk, tisk, tisk. When I really leave, then you'll see what you all got. Good luck filling my shoes. Yeah, it's like, bro, yes, there's some dope-ass white rappers, but bro, I'm another breed. I'm another breed of white rapper. Not just a white rapper, a rapper in general. Then you'll see what you all got. Good luck filling my shoes, I'm a size y'all not. But when it's all done and I really do leave, don't grieve, I'll be right upstairs rolling my weed. Honestly, okay, y'all gone, wish you came with me. Biggest party in the afterlife. Yo, since they claim big, about to pour a shot on him, pouring out for the homies. Biggie in the champagne room doing Molly and coke. Well, down on earth I'm living on through all the songs that I wrote. I'll be up in the balcony. I'll be living throughout the songs that I wrote, and you could see his ghost coming through the speaker, whatever that thing's called. Well, down on earth I'm living on through all the songs that I wrote. I'll be up in the balcony rolling trees and get blown while Amy Winehouse duets with Nina Simone. Thugs mansion at the party doing shots with Pac and Sinatra while we rolling up with Peter Tosh. I like how he's putting like a story. I've been talking about storylines lately a lot. Not storylines, but somebody creating a story through their words. And lots of the time it's corny, but he's doing a really good job too. And you know what? I'm not even going to front. Sometimes I don't like when he says a story because he's not the best at it, but he's doing a magnificent job at it right now. So good. So good. I can just picture dying and then going up there and then seeing everybody. It's like the Grammys, right? But for the people that are dead, and you see Biggie in the crowd, you see all these people, you know what I'm saying? And then there's something Winehouse featuring something else, and they're probably on the stage doing their song as well. I like how he's doing that. That's sick. That's what I got when I heard that. Marley, Chris Farley, and Basquiat. Till I dip with Marilyn Monroe, giving me time. Shit, it's all good on the skyway, just cruising with James Gandolfini, lighting up a cube. Okay. Pull up at the pearly gates, looking like a boss. Ask Bob Ross, yo, the celebration going on. Yeah. Ain't no COVID up here, should we pack in a room? Only one wearing a mask is MF Doom. So the only one wearing a mask is MF Doom. If y'all haven't heard of MF Doom, y'all been sleeping. There. It's that guy right up there. And you know what? I'm not going to say like I'm a huge fan, but I know the importance of him in hip hop. The guy was a master at wordplay, and just his lyrics were just crazy good. Like Earl Sweatshirt, he looks up to him. And Earl Sweatshirt is one of the best lyricists of this generation. I think he's better than Eminem personally. Y'all can fight me down below, but I'm a die on that hill. And so, if he looks up to MF Doom, you gotta think about that for a second. Like, sheesh, MF Doom, I need to listen to some more. I'm gonna react to a song of his soon. Should we pack in a room? Only one wearing a mask is MF Doom. So when you hear the bass banging from the sky and you wonder why, that's just a party on the other side. That's just a party on the other side. Yo, this is so creative the way he did this. Oof, I love the last verse. Last verse was my favorite. Showered with champagne. They say my name when they notice me. When I'm gone, they gon' wish they were coming. Cause you ain't never met a soul like me. Yo, that was fire. Fire, fire, fire. Oh, the last two songs that Webby's came out with, Inappropriate and this song, he's killed every single one. My favorite thing, if he did a featured song with Yellow Wolf, I'd go berserk, guys. I'd go berserk. But this was just dope. Dope. I love the story telling at the ending about heaven and him seeing all these people. Like I said, it's like I can just picture him going up to heaven, opening up a door to the Grammys and just everybody that's dead sitting around, people doing concerts at the stage. It's just amazing. I'm gonna give him a 10 out of 10 for this. This is the best storytelling he's ever done, in my opinion. Unless you've heard a better one, tell me down below. I'd love to listen to it. And the beat, woohoo, him singing that jazzy beat, I give that a 10 too. Easy, easy. I know I'm a little bit biased as well, but this was just too fire. 10 out of 10 out of everything. But guys, I love y'all so much. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit that like button. Hit that bell notification thingy majiggy. Do it on instead of personalized so you can see all my videos. Now I'm a dip. I love y'all. Peace out.